Good morning, students. Here we are on the third lecture of carboxylic acids and their derivatives. In this part, we will discuss about important chemical reaction of carboxylic acids. Right? Let's see. In the last part, we had discussed about acidic properties of carboxylic acid. And here we are, acidic property, it means, remember, acidic properties, it means the reaction of C double bond O, OH bond. The acidic properties are the reaction or due to this OH bond. That OH, H will be separated out, and that's why these reactions occur, right? Acidic reaction occurs due to release of hydrogen ion, right? So these reactions are related with the properties of OH group. Now we are going to discuss about the properties related between CO bond, COH group, because of the cleavage of this bond, right? Remember, the such type of reaction in which the cleavage of COH bond observed are known as nucleophilic addition elimination reaction. Nucleophilic addition elimination reaction, right? Nucleophilic addition elimination reaction. Reactions involved reactions caused by the bond cleavage of OH that are acidic reaction. In those reactions, COH will show acidic nature. But in which CO bond, C single bond O bond is involved, cleavage of C single bond O is involved, are known as nucleophilic addition elimination reaction. You can see in these reactions, a nucleophile will attack over there and OH will, nucleophile will attack over there and this OH group ejected or removed. Right? So nucleophile will attack and a group which is present earlier, like OH, will remove. Right? That's why nucleophile attack and elimination. Right? So nucleophilic addition and elimination reactions are these reactions termed in each and every reaction. Like in first reaction, you can see here formation of anhydride. In this reaction, you can see P2O5 or any concentrated acid is used, followed by heating also there. And in this condition, one group is act as an electrophile and another group will act as a nucleophile. One group act as an electrophile and another group act as a nucleophile. Simply I can say from these two OH, H2O is removed and an anhydride is formed. Why it is anhydride? Because the H2O is removed after the reaction. So that's why it is anhydride. Okay, so formation of anhydride, here we are going to discuss about. So I'm sharing that here with you also. So CH3, C double bond O, OH is there, right? Acidic condition is there, H plus heating, or P2O5 is there, heating. In both the cases, the same procedure will occur. This pair of electrons shared with H plus. In P2O5, this pair of electrons shared with the vacant d orbital of phosphorus. In that condition, what will happen? CH3, C double bond O, OH2 plus is formed. And afterward, another molecule of CH3, C double bond OH will be attacked, will attack there, this bond will be shifted above. So this CH3C O minus OH2 plus is there, and here is OH plus, and you can see this oxygen will attack over there, so that will be OH plus and C double bond O CH3. In the next step, what will happen in the next step? This H2O will be removed. This bond, minus will attack, put bond here due to for the formation of C double bond O. So, and this hydrogen is also removed. We can say this hydrogen will be will be removed. This H2O will be removed, and the remaining is CH3 C double bond O O C double bond O CH3. Here is C double bond O, C double bond O, CH3. So this is anhydride, right? So simply it is, one molecule will attack, OH will be removed. Obviously, if O will attack, so hydrogen yahan se remove ho jayega. So this is nucleophilic, first nucleophilic addition and then elimination. So that's why it is called nucleophilic addition elimination mechanism. I think it is very much clear to you now. The second reaction you can see, this is esterification, is that again the same reaction. In this reaction, if we are talking about esterification reaction, in the same reaction, in esterification reaction, CH3 C double bond O OH is attacked by any alcohol C2H5OH like, in presence of acidic condition. The use of acid, I think, very much clear to you now. I'm not again repeating that. This will attack over there, OH will be coming out. So CH3 C double bond O, or obviously O will attack, so hydrogen yahan se niklega hi niklega, so O C2H5. This is esterification reaction. This is what, and H, obviously H2O bahar nikalta hai, that we know very well. H plus will act as a catalyst. Right, so in this reaction again you can see what is happening. Again nucleophile will be added and a group is removed. So that is also again known as nucleophilic addition elimination reaction. Right, this is esterification reaction. This is what esterification reaction. The mechanism here you can see, ROH will attack over there. ROH will attack over there. It lose that hydrogen. OH will take hydrogen and remove in the form of H2O. Yes or no? So this is the mechanism of this process also. Right? Attack of nucleophile, lose of water. Right? So this is again the same process. This is the mechanism of esterification you can see. Mechanism is very similar as I have mentioned earlier already. Right? So formation of anhydride, esterification. Some other reactions we had already discussed, the reaction of PCl5, PCl3, SOCl2 in place of OH, Cl will be bonded. The mechanism will be same. Right? And in this mechanism, the phosphorus will be bonded with this oxygen, right? In with PCl5, remember the reaction mechanism is very important to understand what is the process. Again, the same process is there. How? Like CH3 C double bond O OH, okay? And the reaction of OCl2, right? S double bond O Cl is there, Cl is there, okay? So this bond form bond with this first, so this will be CH3 C double bond O and OH, and it gives pair of electron to sulfur, so this will be SO Cl, and Cl is there, right? And when this bond is removed, in that case this Cl will be ejected from here and will attack over there, so will turn into CH3 CO Cl, isn't it? So the mechanism is almost similar, Very easy it is, whatever it is, PCl5, PCl3 or SOCl2, this Cl will attack on this carbon and OH will be removed. Isn't it? So again this very simple method. और वेरी ऑर्डनरी, अगर आप उसे समझना चाहें तो बड़े आसानी से आप रिएक्शन बना सकते हैं. वन मोर रिएक्शन इट इज विद अमोनिया. सो अमोनिया के साथ रिएक्शन क्या होगा? सो व्हेन अगेन यू कैन नाउ इजीली अंडरस्टैंड और इजीली फाइंड द प्रोडक्ट व्हाट रिएक्शन विल अकर विद अमोनिया. अमोनिया हैज अ लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, यस और नो? अमोनिया हैज अ लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन CH3 C डबल बॉन्ड OOH एंड NH3. सो इट विल अटैक ओवर देयर. सो द कंपाउंड विल बी CH3 CO-. ऑब्वियसली कार्बन की वैलेंसी चार से ज्यादा तो नहीं हो सकते. एंड NH3+ एंड OH, राइट? दिस इज सिंपली वी कैन राइट इट एट CH3 COONH4 अमोनियम एसीटेट. सिंपली इट इज अमोनियम एसीटेट. वॉट हैपन देन? वॉट हैपन देन? नाउ दिस NH3 विल लूज इलेक्ट्रॉन, लूज प्रोटोन, बिकॉज चार बॉन्ड है, नाइट्रोजन ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव है तो डेफिनेटली H+ लूज करेगा. एंड दिस OH विल bonded with the proton. So this we may called intramolecular hydrogen transfer also, right? So the product will be CH3 CO- and it is NH2 and it will be OH2+. Equilibrium step it is. NH3 ka concentration jyada hoga to forward direction mein reaction jayega like this. And afterwards this bond will shift to again there to form C double bond O. So this will be CH3 C double bond O NH2. So here you can see how can be prepared anhydride, how can be prepared ester, how can be prepared acid halide, and how can be prepared amides, right? All these reactions are there, yes or no? So these reactions are very important, these reactions are very important for preparation of acid derivative, because these all four are acid derivative. Why they are termed as acid derivative? Because they are prepared from acids, that's why they are termed as acid derivative. One more important reaction is given here. You can see in this reaction NH3 will combine with both the units, COH units, and CONH4 CONH2 banate hain. Fir ek NH2 will attack over there एंड उसमें से भी एक NH3 निकल जाता है, दैट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट थैलीमाइड. एक्चुअली इट इज गिवन हेयर, बट आई कैन शेयर वन मोर मैकेनिज्म रिलेटेड विद इट विच इज आई थिंक मोर कंसिडर मोर यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड बेटर. दिस इज कॉल्ड थैलिक एसिड, COOH. फिनोफ्थलीन में यही एसिड यूज होता है. थैलिक एसिड और फिनॉल आपस में मिलकर जो है वो फिनोफ्थलीन बनाते हैं. कॉम्पोजिशन जो है बेसिकली उसी से बनता है, थैलिक एसिड. इन दिस केस व्हाट विल हैपन, NH3 विल अटैक ओवर देयर. यू कैन सी, मान लीजिए इस कार्बन पर अटैक कर रहा है, राइट? ये यहाँ पर अटैक किया CO बाहर, OH बाहर, यस और नो? द मैकेनिज्म वी नो वेरी वेल. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, C डबल बॉन्ड ONH2, जैसे हमने इस मैकेनिज्म देखा वैसे ही NH2, एंड हेयर इज COOH. And now this NH2 again attack on this carbon. So in this case, this again attack on this carbon, and in this case it will convert into, so C double bond O, and यहाँ से भी OH निकल जाएगा with the same mechanism, and this is called thalimide. It is termed as what? Thalimide. Yes or no? I think very much clear to you now. तो थैलिक एसिड से थैलीमाइड बन जाता है. कोई भी कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, एसिटिक एसिड है तो एसिटामाइड बन जाएगा. इथेनोइक एसिड विच इज कॉल्ड ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज एसिटिक एसिड विल टर्न इनटू इथेनामाइड, यस और नो? सो आई शेयर्ड द नेमिंग ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड ऑल्सो, हाउ कैन बी राइट द नेम ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड इंडिविजुअली, राइट? सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू यू, रिमेंबर. So this is the fourth reaction, that is reaction with ammonia. So here we had discussed all the acid derivative, preparation of acid derivative also, right? Formation of anhydride, for ester, and then ester, and then acid halide and that amide, right? Here the reduction reaction. Reduction reaction on three bases. Acid and their derivatives reduced. One is by LiLH4, right? Acid halide NaBH4 से भी हो जाता है और Rosenbond reaction में एक अलग condition भी देखने को मिलती है. But generally LiLH4 से they all convert into alcohol. Acid halide NaBH4 से भी alcohol में convert हो जाता है. बाकी other नहीं change होते. So LiLH4 is required which convert all the acid and their derivative into alcohols. Diol except amide, okay? Diol will convert all the acid and their derivative into aldehyde, including amide. Amide differ with LiLH4 only. Baki reactions sabke liye same hi hote hain. Okay, and P plus HI, this acid or acid derivative will turn into alkyl group. For example, अगर मैं इस reaction के बारे में आपसे share कर रहा हूँ, so for example, I need to share it with you. For example, if we have any compound like CH3COOH, so with LiLH4, it will turn into CH3CH2OH with the diol aluminium hydride, it will turn into CH3CHO, and with P plus HI, it will turn into CH3CH3. So these are reduction process. It all depends how much हमने diol का mechanism भी देखा हुआ है, the same reaction will occur. We had already discussed about diol and LiLH4 in LiLH4 in alcohols and diol in aldehydes. And here we are discussing P plus HI. P plus HI gives high percentage of hydrogen molecule. Concentration obviously. So in that condition all COH group is reduced into CH3CH3. That's it. Nothing else. So this reaction is very important again. Right, remember it. The next reaction, that is the decarboxylation reaction. Decarboxylation reaction we had discussed earlier in class 11th, where first reaction we had discussed that soda lime reaction, and the second reaction we had discussed in Kolbe's electrolysis method. Right, in soda lime method, here it is given. I'm sharing both the reactions with you here. In soda lime reaction, what will happen? CH3 C double bond O OH. First it react with NaOH and turn into CH3 C double bond O ON. Right? And afterward, in soda lime reaction I'm talking about, C double bond O ONA react with NaOH, and there is 3:1, 3 part NaOH and 1 part CaO. CaO is here to maintain the alkaline atmosphere. The combination of these two is called soda lime. Right, now here what happened, this electron will put bond here, and this condition, this alkyl group will like this. So CH3 minus plus this CaCO2 and Na plus formed here. The CO2 and dissolved in NaOH, whatever other things occur. But remember, carb anion formed in the mechanism, in the reaction. Carb anion, that's why it is called carb anion intermediate method. So how जैसा जैसा कार्बेनाइन स्टेबलाइज होता है उतना बेहतर प्रोडक्ट देखने को मिलता है. बट इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि CO2 बाहर निकलता है. राइट, आफ्टरवर्ड यू कैन सी दिस CH3 माइनस will take H2O, will take hydrogen from H2O, OH and H is there. So we'll take hydrogen because it is basic, it is acidic. So we'll take hydrogen from here and this bond will be shift here. So the final product will be CH4 and OH minus, right? So basic condition is there. So in this condition, what will happen? Simply I can say, जो कि आप याद रख सकते हैं कि alkane बनता है, it is very important, CH3, C double bond O and sodium salt of carboxylic acid use होता है. And simply, how can we remember? The mechanism is different. How can we remember the mechanism? I shared it also with you, already with you. This is, इसको निकाल दीजिए and the remaining will be. So ये अलग हो गया, Na2CO3 it will be. Na2CO3 it will be and the plus is CH4 it is. Yes or no? So it is, I think, very much clear to you now. Right? You can easily understand what is this reaction. And another reaction, that is Kolbe's electrolysis method that we had already discussed about also. Now you can easily understand that reaction. CH3COONA in solution it is, if it is aqueous condition it will give CH3CO minus and Na plus. In 11th it is difficult to describe the mechanism of it because 11th mein aap electrolysis ke baare mein bahut jyada nahi jante the, but now you can understand easily electrolysis. So at anode what reaction will occur, you can see here CH3COO minus will release an electron and convert into, अब अगर देखिए O minus, obviously double bond O और O के ऊपर minus होगा, अगर ये electron lose कर दे तो what will remain? अगर हम CH3CO minus का structure लिखते हैं तो क्या होता है, CH3C double bond O and O minus, तो O minus means there is three lone pair of electrons, right? But अगर एक electron lose हो जाए तो यहाँ पर एक electron single बचा रहेगा, मतलब ये radical बचा रहेगा. So O free radical and here is that one electron, anode पर oxidation होता है. So this reaction will occur. In the next step, again a free radical formation because यहाँ C double bond O bond हो रहा है, तो यहाँ से देखिए आधा radical, आधा electron जब जाता है तो half arrow show करते हैं, तो यहाँ पर भी half arrow, दोनों ने मिलकर bond बनाया तो obviously यहाँ पर एक electron बचा रहेगा. So this will be CH3 free radical and the CO2 is there. Right? And then 2 CH3 free radical, या जो भी alkyl group हैं, उनके 2 CH3 free radical will combine and turn into C2H6. So I shared about this reaction that कि CO हटा दीजिए और जो भी ग्रुप्स हैं उन दोनों को जोड़ दीजिए. Right? तो आपका final product आपको मिल जाएगा. Cathode पर क्या produce होगा? अगर हम देखें cathode पर क्या जाएगा? If we are talking about कि cathode पर क्या form होगा? So in that condition cathode पर Na plus है और water है. Cathode पर क्या Na plus है water है, तो obviously I think you can easily understand कि Na plus तो reduce होगा नहीं, तो water will reduce and turn into H2, two molecules of water will reduce and turn into H2 and OH minus, two molecules of OH minus and two electrons. This is very usual question competition. I don't know कि स्कूल एग्जाम्स में कभी आता है या नहीं आता है, जहाँ तक मुझे याद है कि आया है शायद, कि what will happen, what is the nature of the reaction mixture after and at the end of the reaction. So it is very much clear that Na plus and OH minus is there. So as reaction proceed, as reaction progress, the nature of reacting mixture or the electrochemical cell increasing toward basic nature or pH increase we can say, right? Or dimerization of C2H6 product banta hai. I shared the mechanism here. I'm sharing the short trick method, how can we identify what will be the product, right? So electrolysis ke baad you just need to remember about ki kya hoga. ये सब भूल जाइए, जो भी CONA हैं, इन दो जो भी दो ग्रुप्स यहाँ पर हैं बस इन्हें डायमराइज कर दीजिए. सो CH3 एंड दैट विल बी CO2 एंड द रिमेनिंग इज NaOH एंड एज यू नो H2 भी फॉर्म होता है. सो दीज आर बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द रिएक्शन. राइट। तो अगर आप बहुत ध्यान से देखें, इफ वी हैव लाइक दिस एनी रिएक्टेंट COONA, राइट, इन दैट कंडीशन व्हाट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट, सॉरी नॉट नोरिंग इन साइड्स, इन दैट कंडीशन दिस विल बी द प्रोडक्ट। दो यहाँ से एक्चुअली यहाँ पर फ्री रेडिकल्स बनेंगे और दो इस तरीके से आपस में जुड़ जाएंगे, सो दिस विल बी योर प्रोडक्ट, राइट। तो आपको कुछ भी नहीं करना है, इसको हटाइए और बाकी दोनों को जोड़ दीजिए। सो सिंपल मेथड्स में, नॉर्मल मेथड्स में, नॉर्मल प्रोसेस में ये आपके लिए बहुत काम आ जाएगा और आपका रिएक्शन भी कंप्लीट हो जाएगा। सो दीज टू रिएक्शंस अंडर डीकार्बोक्सिलेशन रिएक्शन, बट आई नीड टू शेयर सम अदर डीकार्बोक्सिलेशन रिएक्शन ऑल्सो विद यू बिकॉज दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। आई एम टेकिंग सम मिनट्स फॉर यू फॉर इट, राइट। सो रिमेंबर सम कंपाउंड्स लाइक कॉल्ड बीटा कीटो एसिड लाइक CH3, C डबल बॉन्ड O, CH2 एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड CH2COOH, दिस इज अल्फा, दिस इज बीटा, सो दे आर कॉल्ड बीटा कीटो एसिड। इन दिस एसिड ऑन हीटिंग दीज एसिड, रिमेंबर ऑन हीटिंग दीज एसिड व्हाट विल हैपन, जब हम इन एसिड्स को हीट करते हैं सो CO2 जो है वो रिमूव हो जाता है हीटिंग पर, ये थोड़े से अनस्टेबल टाइप के होते हैं और हीटिंग पर ये CO2 रिलीज हो जाता है। तो CO2 बस आपको हटाना है अगर बीटा कीटो एसिड है, सो द प्रोडक्ट विल बी CH3 सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ CH3 ऑन हीटिंग बीटा कीटो एसिड। देयर इज अ रिंग फॉर्मेशन अकर, आई एम नॉट शेयरिंग दैट मैकेनिज्म बिकॉज इट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू, बट देयर इज अ रिंग फॉर्मेशन अकर थ्रू विच दिस कंपाउंड विल कन्वर्ट इन टू कीटोन, राइट। वन मोर कंपाउंड विच इज कॉल्ड जैम डायकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, जैम डायकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, जैम डायकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड मीन्स देयर टू COH ग्रुप एट अ कार्बन। ऑन हीटिंग जैम डायकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड अगेन अ CO2 मॉलिक्यूल इज रिमूव्ड एंड द कंपाउंड विल बी ऑब्वियसली CO2 निकल जाएगा तो ये CH3 आ जाएगा तो CH3COOH। दिस इज अगेन द रिएक्शन कंप्लीटेड बाय द रिएक्शन कंप्लीटेड बाय रिंग फॉर्मेशन, राइट। वन मोर रिएक्शन विच इज बीटा गामा अनसेचुरेटेड CH2 डबल बॉन्ड CH2COOH अल्फा बीटा गामा, बीटा गामा अनसेचुरेटेड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, इनको भी जब हम हीट करते हैं तो इन दैट कंडीशन यहां से CO2 निकल जाता है और प्रोडक्ट बनता है CH2 डबल बॉन्ड CH2। ये भी रिंग फॉर्मेशन के थ्रू रिएक्शन कंप्लीट होता है। सो ये रिएक्शन भी डीकार्बोक्सिलेशन रिएक्शन होता है और इन तीनों के अलावा और किसी कंडीशन में जनरली वन दैट वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कोलबेज एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस एंड सोडा लाइम मेथड, अपार्ट फ्रॉम देम ये रिएक्शंस भी डिकार्बोक्सिलेशन करते हैं। सो रिमेंबर दीज, ये कंपाउंड्स भी डिकार्बोक्सिलेशन करते हैं, सो रिमेंबर दीज कंपाउंड्स, राइट। सो दिस इज डिकार्बोक्सिलेशन रिएक्शन वी आर डिस्कसिंग नाउ। दिस इज नेम्ड रिएक्शन विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दिस इज कॉल्ड हेल्बोल्हार्ड-ज़ेलेंस्की रिएक्शन। What? Helbolhard-Zelensky reaction. This is a named reaction and it is actually the product formed is halogenated. Halogenation occur at alpha position. In the formed product halogenation occur in alpha position. Right? You can see here this is carboxylic acid. In presence of P plus X2, red phosphorus plus X2, hydrogen will be that X will be bonded with the alpha carbon. So they are called halocarboxylic acid. Hydrogen will be bonded with alpha carbon. So they are called what? Halocarboxylic acid. So these are the reaction of this alpha carbon and on this carbon halogen is bonded. Helmholtz-Zelenski reaction. There is a mechanism through which it occurs actually, but it is not important for you. That's why I'm not sharing with you. Definitely, I will share the reaction. Go through the reaction mechanism portion after completion of your syllabus in class 12, because the basics are very necessary. So I will share such mechanism. This reaction or some type of reaction also occur with aldehyde and ketones in acidic conditions also. But remember, this is the reaction of alpha position, right? इस पोजीशन पर अल्फा पोजीशन पर एक्स ऐड होगा. इतने से अगर आप याद रखेंगे सो इट विल बी वेरी गुड. और उससे ज़्यादा कि आपको खासकर जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी नॉर्मल कंडीशंस में, राइट? कुछ और स्टेप्स होते हैं बट दे आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड हियर. दैट्स आई एम नॉट शेयरिंग. बट इट इज रिएक्शन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन स्कूल एग्जामिनेशन एज वेल एज फॉर कॉम्पिटिशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. रिमेंबर इट इज. नाउ हेयर वी आर द लास्ट पोर्शन, द इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन. एज वी नो द कार्बोक्सिलिक ग्रुप इज deactivating group. I shared the properties of deactivating group already with you. So in deactivating group, the bond which is the atom which is bonded with the ring bonded with more electronegative atom. जब भी ऐसा होगा, that's why I said कि carbonyl compound जितने भी होते हैं सारे deactivating nature के होते हैं, right? So COH is again deactivating. Deactivating means it decreases the activity of ring toward electrophilic substitution reaction. यानी अगर हम benzene और benzoic acid के ESR electrophilic substitution reaction की बात करें तो benzoic acid की reactivity कम होती है और benzene की ज़्यादा होती है. बाकी obviously matter directing होते हैं, तो जो भी nitration होता है, bromination होता है, we had discussed many reaction related with you. So it would occur at meta position, right? So remember these points also very necessary. So this is the part that we have to discuss with you in the syllabus of class 12, carboxylic acid. Apart from it, I want to say this is और भी बहुत सारा ऐसा पार्ट है जो कि इम्पॉर्टेंट होता है, बट वी कैन डिस्कस दैट पार्ट और वी वुड डिस्कस दैट पार्ट आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ योर सिलेबस. आई विल शेयर वीडियोज एंड अदर थिंग्स बिकॉज मेरे पास अगर समय होगा तो वहाँ डेफिनेटली मैं शेयर करूँगा और रिएक्शन मैकेनिज्म पर आपसे मैं बहुत सारी बातें करूँगा उससे रिलेटेड. ओके, बट विच इज़ इंक्लूडेड इन योर सिलेबस, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट. थैंक यू फॉर टुडे.